No, I would step to him a little bit. I wouldn't be. Oh!
They train again. Oh! Ruiz got caught with a hard shot. Now Arreola is pounding right hands on him.
Behind those fast hands.
Oh! Now Ruiz is hurt again. A counter left hook from Arreola. They're trading and Areola's getting.
Oh!
Ruiz is hurt again.
And he's.
They're letting it fly now. Who's landing and Ruiz is starting to get the better of it. And now what happened with Arreola with his arm?
Oh!
Big hook. And he shakes the arm again. Areola's hurt. Says, I'm all right, I can continue. But that shoulder is bothering him. Well, that's a hell of a fight. Brian Kenny, Lennox Lewis, and in a scene from Dances with Wolves, Shawn Porter. Like this.
Listen, I was cold, and I found a way through.
It's not frozen, by the way. We're doing all right. But I tell you what, Lennox, that was more than anticipated. Even though we thought it would be a great collision, that was an exciting fight.
Oh, it was a lot closer than we thought. I mean, you know, I wasn't expecting Chris to come out like that. He came out smart. You know, he had a game plan. This is what, you know, a lot of boxers come in there and they never have game plans, but he had a game plan. He had a great trainer and he stuck to the game plan.
And not only that, Sean, as we mentioned, was that you?
Yeah, that's me.
I'm getting near you again. What fascinated me, though, is we were talking about the nuances of fight, was that Ruiz thought, all right, I got knocked down. I got knocked down against Joshua, too. I came roaring back and almost starched him. He went back to do that to Arreola, and it was like, no.
Yeah.
Can't do that. So he learned mid-fight.
Yeah.
Let me change my direction here. Explain what you saw in him changing tactics.
That part to me was amazing. It was amazing how he changed his pace. He decided to start taking some steps back and playing counterpuncher and right around round five, and he found some success right there. I think that he was able to slow down Chris and was able to get Chris off of his game plan in terms of being smart and working behind his jab. Now Chris has got to move forward and be the attacker, and that wasn't what Chris wanted to do tonight.
And I remember, like, you against Sebastian Formella last time you fought in August, you went from one tactic and then suddenly you got on your toes and you were sticking and moving.
Yeah.
How difficult is it to say, hey, I'm going to change tactics mid-fight?
That's what makes you a champion, and that's what gives me faith that Andy Ruiz can become a champion again. When you're willing to do whatever it takes to win a fight, you're open enough to understand this is my adjustment, make that adjustment, execute, you win.
That shows a very high boxing IQ.
Absolutely.
Lennox, your thoughts overall on what you saw from the return of Andy Ruiz after losing the title, being overweight, coming back and going 12 hard rounds?
Well, like he said, he's not 100%, and he didn't want to tell give the percentage of where he was at, but you know, he adjusted well. He came back from a hard shot, and there was a couple times where he could have fell down, but he fought through it and came back, and you've seen his determination. And he wanted to do good, but he didn't do as well as he wanted to do this fight. He could always do better. That's why he wants to do it again.
I tell you what, you think about it, do you want to see it again? I don't know. I wouldn't mind seeing it again.
I wouldn't mind seeing it.
It was pretty good. And look, I understand Chris Arreola's frustration where he said, wait a second, I was in that fight. And he was. It was competitive. But I don't think the judging was poor in this. I think it just is what it is. But we learned a lot.
Let me tell you what Chris Arreola needed to do. He needed to throw a lot more body shots. You know, mix up the shots. He was really just aiming for the head.
Yeah.
Hey, and Chris Arreola, now age 40, he looked very much like a top 10 heavyweight, didn't he? Like, I don't know, maybe he's more like number 12 or 11. I don't know if he's better than, say, Alexander Usyk, Tori Michael Hunter.
Right.
But he's right around there now. He's not an also-ran.
Well, you know what? Let's speak to Andy Ruiz as it pertains to that. Andy didn't take on a nobody in the return fight.
Right. Yeah.
He took on Chris Arreola. That's not an easy night, as you can see. He weathered this storm right here, or early storm. He came back and did his thing.
For all the best boxing content, follow PBC on Fox on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. Thank you for watching. Well, if you enjoyed that clip, make sure you click somewhere around here and subscribe. From fight highlights to exclusive interviews, we have got everything you need as a boxing fan right here on PBC on Fox.